Let's play. What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 21 of the Ultimate Let's Play Advanced Wars Days of Ruin. And we are about to take on our final battle against Admiral Greyfield, and this is going to be a big one. Hi, Admiral Greyfield. How can I help you?
Calder, what in the name of Rubenel do you think you're doing?
Whatever do you mean?
Don't play the fool with me. That virus is tearing through my troops. Where is my cure? I ordered you to find one.
Yes, the creeper, the green thumb. I hear it is causing problems in the ranks. It seems your policy of executing the infected has actually worsened morale. Fascinating.
How dare you question me? Who are you? Just some pathetic man in a lab coat.
Treating your infected troops in such a manner has sowed the seeds of discontent. Rather than seek help, infected soldiers conceal the truth for fear of the firing squad. This has allowed the disease to spread almost unimpaired through your army.
Silence! I will hear no more of this. I am not a man to be taken lightly, Calder. If you had done your job, none of this would be a problem. Get me a cure by the end of the week, or I will have you executed.
Is everything all right, Admiral? You look somewhat unwell.
What do you mean? How dare you mock the mighty Greyfield?
Not another word, Admiral. Your eyes tell me all I need to know. You too are infected with the virus. And that vaccine of yours can only hold it off for so long.
Bah! Bah! Admiral Greyfield will not be brought below by some common virus. Only the weak succumb to this disease, and I am not among their number. I am strong.
Your fear is palpable. If word it spread that you had been infected, your army would crumble. You said yourself that this virus affects only the weak, did you not? I wonder, Admiral, will you order your own firing squad to execute you as well?
Insolence! I'll see you hang for this!
Admiral, if you send me to swing, you'll never find your cure. But worry not, your little secret will be safe with me. And as we speak, I am but hours away from perfecting a cure.
Truly?
Truly.
Then all is forgiven. Oh, Calder, you devil, I was right to trust you. I want this cure delivered to all my troops without delay. But first, give it to me. Not that a man of my strength will need it. It's just to show the men that I am one of them.
Yes, yes, you and your troops will get your medicine in due time. But first we must discuss my masterpiece. The preparations are almost complete.
Ha ha, my time of destiny is at hand. Admiral Greyfield shall rule the world as king. Show me how to operate it. Show me your masterpiece.
From this room, you can control the launch systems for the Calder missiles. You will rain destruction down upon the entire world.
You outdo yourself, Calder. No leader has ever wielded the power I now possess. With this button, my destiny's fulfilled. I will become King Greyfield the Mighty. Now where are those miserable traitors cowering? They shall get the first taste.
Do calm yourself, Admiral. The launch system was heavily damaged by the meteor strikes. There are a number of locking mechanisms that must be bypassed before it can be used. My staff estimates that it will be 40 days before the launch can commence.
That is unacceptable. Tell him to hurry. I want those wretched traitors to feel the full force of my wrath. Make them hurry. Tell them King Greyfield orders it to be so.
Commander, Greyfield's army's here. All of them.
That force is huge. Maybe we should retreat and plan a strategy.
There isn't time. We must strike them now and find Greyfield. We need to learn the status of those Calder missiles.
I can help. The launch system was damaged, but is being restored as we speak. The process will be complete in 40 days. Once launched, the missiles will cause anyone in the blast range to suffer.
Thank you, Isabella. Don't think I need to hear all the details.
Alright, we have to stop them. I'll take the troops and...
No, I'll do it. I mean, permission to lead the troops, Commander.
Why?
I know you and Brenner were close, but he was my captain. I failed him. I owe him this. Plus, I have the virus and you don't. I have nothing to lose.
Alright, so Lin's going to take control of the army here.
Greyfield's strength lies with his navy. Move your ground forces with care. We must gain control of the seas. Use rigs to build temporary ports.
Alright, well, I've got a few strategies of my own, Lin, but thanks for the advice. But he's going to have... I mean, look at the size of my armada. Plus, we're dealing with fog of war, but looking at his unit counter, it's 21 against 21. So, Lin is obviously going to want to take control of the seas. So, luckily, we got a few cruisers, a battleship, a few subs. I'm also going to want to start capturing some properties over there. Not to mention, I have a 40-day time limit on this mission. So, if the 40 days pass, the Calder missiles will launch and destroy the world. But hopefully, the strategies that I'm going to be using will give me time to spare. I'm going to try and clear this in around, I would say, 8 or 9 turns. And obviously, I'm going to be handling a lot of units here. I got several different fronts. Looks like it's going to be like a 3 or 4 pronged attack here. So I don't know where Greyfield's units are going to be coming from. And I am going to be going for an HQ capture. His HQ is in the top left corner of the map. Subs are definitely going to be valuable in breaking through Fog of War. As a matter of fact, this is Lin's specialty map, Fog of War. I think she has extended range. And I think her CO power extends it even further. And maybe I'll get to show that off later on. Okay, here we go. Restoration of the Calder missile launch system is now 2.5% complete. It will be fully operational in 39 days.
Splendid! I can hardly wait! My glorious reign as king is about to begin! Those traitors will serve as an example for all the world!
Not if, I have anything to do with it, Greyfield. Okay, he's brought forth it's an anti-tank unit. I'm gonna blow it away with my rockets here. I do have a flare unit I can use as well. Start capturing this port and bringing up another infantry on the left side to capture the city. Got my bike capturing that port. Terms of battling in the sea, nothing's really in sight right now, so I'm gonna try and keep the units as bunched together as possible and just do a full-out frontal assault here. And what I'm also gonna do is pop Lynn into the sub. She doesn't have a real good CO zone, but I could use her CO power later on if I need to. Her CO power is called Scout, which basically extends her line of sight and fog of war. Also will reveal hidden enemies in the forests and cities that we can't normally see. I think what Greyfield's going to do is going to try and plant some infantry in the island that I'm on. So I'm using my war tank and my other unit, the rig, the loaded rig, and my lander to try and block them. I revealed a couple more units here. Kind of retreating.
Treacherous swine! Inglorious backstabbing vermin!
You are one charming fellow, Greyfield.
You pathetic traitors understand nothing. You can't see that war is caused by the fact that other nations exist. I shall be the man to unite all the world into one nation. I will be the man to end all war forever.
And humble, too. I like it.
Say the sarcastic asides for your tombstone, dog. That meteor strike and all that followed was a test. The situation demands that a natural leader unite the survivors below him. And I, King Greyfield, shall be that leader.
That's a great plan, but let me ask you something. Once everyone's below you, will you stop being such a coward?
What? You dare to...
I've seen your records. I know you were subpar commander at best. And you know it too. That's why you strut around like a playground bully. You hate your shame by faking results and taking credit for the work of...
Silence! Enough of your loathsome falsehoods, you treacherous hound!
No, that's enough of you, you lying, sniveling fat man! You're a coward and a liar, and I have had enough of it. You started this fight... Now I'm gonna end it.
Well, and I think you need to work on your insults a little bit, because I could have done a lot better. Just saying. Oh boy. We just found the mother load. I'm seeing at least two carriers there. A battleship, a gunboat, among others. And I'm going to dive this sub as well to extend my range even further. Hopefully I can block some units here. You got to stay together, though. Don't want to put my guys in range accidentally of a hidden battleship. Let's see what's up here. Got a meme tank, a mech, and a regular tank. Let's get these two units over to the east side of the map. Get in formation. My rockets can't hit the mech. Let's see if I can kill it in one shot here. Yes, nice. One-hit knockouts are always good for the power score. And I think I'm just gonna hold for now here. He can't see my hidden sub, luckily. Well, now he can. The seaplane just crashed into it. Yet, he doesn't appear to be going on the offensive. And his landers ran right into my units there. So, they did what they had to do there. So now they gotta get to the corner of the map to go for the HQ. Let's take out this battleship first. And thanks to Lynn being on board, it will go down in one shot. Might have taken two otherwise. Get rid of this gunboat. We really need to take out all these sea units, especially the battleships, because they're going to be covering the HQ with their lives. And because they're high range and I can't hit them, not to mention they can move and fire, we definitely got to take them out. And hopefully, Greyfield won't build any more, so I'm going to have to cover that port as well. And luckily, since I have Lynn in that sub, I should be pretty well covered here. Need to get you off of the port, because what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a carrier at some point and start producing a seaplane. Okay, let's load these guys and start moving them carefully to the northwest side of the map. Fall back a little with these guys. Get them in formation here. Nice thing about that anti-tank is that it can fire indirectly as well as directly. So that's going to be an invaluable tool for if he tries to go for an HQ capture. My HQ is in the southeast corner of the map. Alright, I think I've done everything here. Let's see what Greyfield does. I'm kind of surprised he didn't attack there. He's going after my cruiser now. And I think this cruiser's gonna go down. I was expecting to take a couple of licks here. I don't think I have to worry about the cruisers too much. I mean, as long as I have the subs, I should be in good shape. Let's go ahead and take this guy out. Good shot, Lynn. How should I do this? Definitely want to take that guy out. Just trying to wear everybody down and think of my next move here at the same time. Probably could have gone about this a little bit better. Alright. I'm probably going to need another turn to take out that last battleship anyway. Actually, I may be able to kill it. Let's see what happens. I don't think it's going to be quite enough, though. I take that back. It was enough. Okay, so now all he's got is a gunboat and that carrier. I'm going to build a carrier of my own. I'm going to have to bail on that city there. Don't want my bike to take any unnecessary damage. Thank you, indirect fire. All think that's all I have to do. I'm leaving my rig on that island because if my sea units start to drop low on fuel or ammo, I can use the rig to restock them. Unfortunately, the way that island is laid out, I'm only going to be able to restock one unit at a time. Hopefully that may be all I need, though. Okay, got a seaplane at the ready. I'm going to launch him next turn. Looks like he built another carrier. That's why I have the cruiser to take out any seaplanes he may launch. Let's get a one-hit KO here. Yes. Work on him. And then I think I can take out that last unit with my remaining sub. Nice. That worked pretty well, I think. Now the tricky part is getting the units up to get to the HQ. So I've got the war tank and my rig as defense. I'll have to drop him next turn, and then it will take at least two turns to capture, pending nothing goes wrong. Okay, let's go ahead and start firing on these guys. Should knock it down to one HP. Or kill it outright. I'm getting pretty lucky with these shots here. I'm getting very lucky. Some of these shouldn't even be doing one-hit knockouts, and they are. Either they got a very slim chance of it happening. Hey, I can't complain. Now he's targeting my lander. Luckily, the lander served its purpose. But now we know there's at least one rocket that I gotta deal with. Looks like two, maybe. Just don't know where they are in location, in terms of where my guys are. He's got a mech near the HQ here. Yep, there's the rocket. Rocket won't be able to hit my infantry, though. Until it moves on to the HQ, so I gotta try and find a way to take that guy out. I'm gonna go ahead and launch my seaplane. Get it in position. Yeah. Lynn was definitely running low on fuel there, so. And I want to keep her on the board, because if looks like my CO meter is about to hit its max, and if I lose Lynn off the map, all that goes away. Lost my lander, but again, served his purpose. I'm going to lose this guy, too. He's firing on the weakened units. I just got to hope he keeps doing that. Going after my war tank. Took a little bit of a hit there, but still should be in pretty good shape. Now he's going after the rig. Okay, so I have to take out that rocket. I got a mech in the way here, so I'm going to go ahead and take it out. Uh-oh. That could be a serious problem. I could send up the seaplane, but I'm worried that there may be a unit or two blocking the way, and my guy may not have enough movement spaces to get around him. I'll go ahead and take this guy out. I All right, well, Lynn just fully powered up here. Okay, so, yeah, her seal power is Scout. I'm going to have to hold off on it for now, though. Oh, boy. I got to do this here. But that means my infantry is going to be under attack. Yeah, I'm pretty much damned if you do, damned if you don't here. He's put another unit on board here. I was afraid of that. He put a mech in the factory. Oh, boy. That could mean serious trouble. My infantry is just going to have to hold on for dear life when trying to capture. We've got half of it done already, but if I get worn down too much, it'll be all for naught. And the strategy is going to go bust here. I'm literally at the point where I got to improvise here, so... And I can't really make any blocks. I just gotta hope for the best. This is exactly what I was hoping would not happen. Had I gotten that mech out of the way, I would have been able to finish this mission next turn. But now I'm gonna have to find a way to avoid getting killed. Luckily, he's attacking me with weak units. I'm down to 6 HP. And now my rig, my line of defense, is gonna go bye-bye. And now he's going after me with his mech. Now I'm down to under half health. And he's got an anti-air unit as well. Okay. Best way to do this. Might as well go ahead and take this guy out. I got that anti-air to deal with. He's gonna need at least another two turns to take this guy, the HQ, out. Go ahead and try and just take out as many units as I can. Not too worried about that one mech unit. If he tries to attack with the 1 HP mech, he's probably going to kill himself. Did some significant damage to the medium tank. Unfortunately, I can't park my cruiser in that port. I'll join the two of them together. I know it's not the best idea in the world to attack a cruiser with a sub, but... just trying to be as cautious as possible, and unfortunately I had to leave that anti-air alive. Which could be bad news for my seaplane. All right. I should be safe, at least for this turn. Lynn, do not die on me now. There goes my seaplane. Oh, it's still alive. Okay. Okay, I was a little worried there. Why are you doing that, Greyfield? Alright, well, I've got an opening here. You know, let's go ahead and use our seal power. A tactician is only as good as her intelligence. It's time for scout. Ground unit vision +2, including hiding places. Let's see where everybody is. Okay, medium tank, mech, and an anti-tank. Alright, so I gotta take this guy out. Unfortunately, my units are kind of limited here. My cruisers can't really do anything about it. He's got a war tank coming. I think the anti-tank can fire upon infantry. I'm not sure though. Off the top of my head. Is that gonna be enough to kill this guy? No. If there's counterfire, it's not enough. Okay. What's gonna be the biggest threat? I don't think the anti-tank can even hit me from that range. I'm definitely more worried about that. Wear the medium tank down. I don't think it will attack with only 1 HP. Alright, that's all I can do. So I gotta hope my infantry has at least 2 HP by the end of this turn. Restoration of the Cauldron Missile launch system is 25% complete. It will be fully operational in 30 days.
Music to my ears. Now work harder.
Well, buddy, you're not going to live past tomorrow. I will guarantee you that. He actually merged the mechs together. He's actually falling back. But now I got to... Oh, boy. Okay, I've got enough HP. As long as he doesn't attack me again, I'm good. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. My infantry held on just long enough to finish the capture. Might as well start killing some units for power. And then I can end this mission and end Greyfield's reign of terror. Nothing I can do over there. Alright. Anything else? No, forget it.
No, 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 no! Idiots! Wretched, lousy, foul, incompetent idiots! All my dreams!
We did it. We actually did it. Yes, we did it. Did I get the S rank? Yes, thank you. Alright, the streak remains intact. A 381. The endgame could have gone a little bit better, but I managed to salvage the S-rank, so I can't complain. Defeat is not an option. Oh boy, that was a fight. I'm so glad that that's over.
Retreat! Retreat! All units retreat! When I find out who's responsible, I will have them executed immediately. I am the supreme leader of the world. I am the strongest of all men. Defeat is only for the weak.
You're right.
Eek.
Defeat is for the weak. You were defeated because you were weak. And now you're gonna die.
You wouldn't dare.
Actually, I would. Will wouldn't. Will would try to put you on trial or something. But Will isn't here, is he?
You wouldn't dare. You can't. You can't do this.
You are responsible for the death of Captain Brenner. You killed him, and now I'm going to kill you. Will and the others won't like it, but it's what needs to be done.
Stop. I surrender. I surrender my forces to you. There, you can't hurt me now. I'm a prisoner of war. Captain Brenner would never hurt a prisoner. It's murder. If you kill me, you're as bad as me. You'll be just the same as me.
Huh. I guess you're right. That was for you, Brenner. I think I'll see you soon.
We did it. We won.
The war is over. You did it. Hurrah for Brenner's wolves.
Will, everyone, listen up. I just discovered huge stocks of the vaccine we need in Greyfield's headquarters. I think we can keep the infected alive long enough for me to find a cure. We did it. We did it. Yeah, we did. Oh, this is no time for frowns. It's over. We won. It's time for the biggest celebration this world has ever seen.
Dr. Morris, I don't think we'll...
You should turn that frown upside down. I'm sorry, Will. What is it? We lost so many people. A better commander could have prevented such losses. I'm just not in the mood for a party. I'm sorry.
Typical. If you were bigger and had better hair, I swear you were actually Brenner.
Lynn,
We all love you, Will, but please, stop feeling sorry for yourself. You're the cadet who defeated an admiral. I think that's good enough.
But without you and Isabella, and...
What you lacked in talent, you made up for with heart and guts. And you inspired every soldier to do the same, even those who never came home. That's what led us to victory. Not my tactics, not Isabella's whatever she does. It was you, and you should be proud. So let's go have a party.
Yeah, all right. Oh, now that's the spirit. Let's party. I've got a few classic jokes that are safe for special occasions. And despite the fact that we just put a bullet in his head, we can now use Greyfield in free play. But anyway, I'm going to call it quits here. We've finally gotten rid of Admiral Greyfield. We're about to be in the final phase of the game in the next episode, the final five missions. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.